A lot of people have been asking me when I'm going back to Game of Thrones, but I can't really say anything yet, you know?
And obviously, Thrones has become a huge global phenomenon. What do you think the secret of the show's success is? Why do people respond to it so well?
Well, it's we've got great actors, and it's great writing, you know? It's all around brilliant, just...
And what does it mean for you personally to be a big part of that?
It's a great thing to be a part of, and it's a great experience, and it's great to say that, you know, it's great to write down on a CV and say that I've been in.
It's a fantastic cast. Can you talk about working with some of the brilliant people alongside you on that?
Well, there's so many people here beside me, but it's great working with Isaac and working with Natalia Tena as well. She's brilliant, and Christian Nair and all them. They're all amazing.
I mean, obviously, we kind of feel like we know them because we're so in love with these characters, but what are they like when the camera stops rolling, like people like Isaac and Nat?
They're all really, really nice, you know. They're definitely really friendly, and to everyone, all the crew and the cast, and yeah, they're really nice.
Season 5's been prompting a big reaction from fans, as always. Have you been keeping up with the show, and how do you feel about Season 5?
I haven't been keeping up with the show. I'm on Season 1. I've just finished Season 1, so I'm on Season 2 now. But my mom doesn't let me watch some of the scenes. But it's still, you know, from what I've heard, it's still an amazing show.
I mean, there are some pretty tough scenes in terms of sex and violence. How do you feel about that? How important is that as an element of the show, do you think?
Well, some people like it, you know. And I'm sure that because it's such a big factor in the books, you know, they want to keep as strictly occupied with the books as possible.
Looking back on Dracula Untold, what was the highlight of that experience for you?
It was definitely working in Belfast for so long and, you know, getting to know Belfast, and working with a director like Gary Shore was also amazing, and yeah.
What do you feel as a young actor you took away, you've learnt from working with someone like Gary and someone like Luke?
Well, they're all brilliant, you know, and they all helped me out through the whole film process and taught me a lot.
What have you got coming up at the moment? Where are we going to see you next?
Well, San Andreas was out last week, or a few weeks ago now, actually. And, yeah, we've got a project that we're doing in LA at the minute called Kubo and the Two Strings with Matthew McConaughey and Charlize Theron. And that should be out in... Well, I don't think I'm allowed to say when that's out yet, actually. Or, well, I don't think it's been planned to come out yet. So that should be out fairly a year or so. And, yeah, we're also going to do a few films over the summer.
I mean, how's the experience of doing voice acting compared to being on screen?
I like it, you know. It's a lot different, you know, from getting up early and going on set and getting makeup and hair done and costume and stuff like that. When you could just walk in a pair of tracksuit bottoms and say a few words, you know. But I thought it was going to be like that, you know, just walking in and saying a few words. But it actually is almost harder than, you know, normal acting, because you have to put all your emotion and all your effort into the one voice.
San Andreas, we had our heart in our mouth for most of that film. Can you talk about your experience making that?
It was brilliant, and I got to do a lot of stunts and stuff like that, and working with Dwayne and Carla and Alex and Hugo, they were all amazing.
I mean, Dwayne obviously is the ultimate action hero. Did he have any tips for you about being a stuntman?
He did, yeah. He just told me to basically listen up, especially when the stuntmen are telling us what to do, because, you know, if something goes wrong, then you can hit your head and get hurt.
What was the toughest stunt you're involved in, or the scariest?
I think it was when the tsunami hit. Sorry for anyone who hasn't seen the film yet, you know, spoiling it a bit, but it was definitely when the tsunami hit. They had this drop tank, and basically it dropped in on me, and it sort of threw me through this water. So, yeah, that was definitely the hardest stunt.
Have you got a message for fans, people who've loved seeing you and stuff and can't wait to see more of you?
I haven't really. Thank you for the support.